Hey guys and welcome again to the channel. Today I will show you how to remove the fuel tank of our motorcycle Interceptor 650 and Continental GT 650. This is a very simple process. I will show you the step how to do it. So guys, let's start the video. To remove the tank, you need a size 10mm spanner or a socket set or a T spanner with a 10mm socket to remove the tank, or you can also use the open end spanner. You also need a towel or a rag to save your tank from the scratches. First step is to remove your seat. I guess everybody knows how to remove the seat, so it's very easy. Now we have to open these two bolts under the seat, which is holding the tank in place, using this 10mm socket and the T handle. See, these are the two bolts which are holding the tank in place. Keep this bolt aside safely. You also need something like this, a wooden block or something, to lift the tank up and hold it in place while you are working on it. I'm using a wooden block. Now we have taken the bolts off which are holding the tank in place on the motorcycle. Another important thing is to straighten up your handlebar and secure the front brake like I'm doing here with the use of a thread. You can use anything, a rope or a cloth or a zip tie, anything you have. This is to make it secure so that the bike won't move forward while you are pushing and pulling the tank. So guys, now we have secured our front brake and we have also kept our handlebar straight and taken the bolts off. We just have to lift the tank little bit, not too much. This much is enough. I just put this lock here and let me just show you what all things you have to remove from under the tank before taking it off. Another thing, before lifting the tank up, just put the cloth or the towel or any rag which you have taken out like this on the tank so that it won't scratch with the front handlebar assembly. So friends, now I have lifted the tank up and hold it in place using this wooden block. Let me show you what all things you have to disconnect before taking the tank off. We have to disconnect 5 things in total. First one is this, the fuel pump coupler which provides the electric supply to the fuel pump. And then this hose, this is on the left side of the tank. This is the water drain hose which drains out the rainwater or the washing water which you put from the hole from the top of your tank cap to the bottom of the motorcycle or on the ground. Now I am on the right side of the tank, friends. So on the right of the tank you see this hose. This is the hose connected from your tank to the evaporation unit of the motorcycle. It is fairly simple to disconnect this evap hose. Just pull this down. So now again from the right side, I have already removed the evap hose. You can see this green coupler. This is the coupler of your fuel gauge. This gives the reading for the quantity of fuel to your instrumental console. So you have to remove this also. And then this, you can see this pipe, this big pipe. It has got a quick release button here. This is the main fuel supply from your tank to your injector. We have to remove this also. So these are the 5 things, friends. First one is the water drain hose on the left hand side of the tank. Then this fuel pump coupler. Then this evap hose. Then this fuel gauge coupler. Then this main fuel supply pipe. We have to remove all these. So first thing we should remove is this fuel pump coupler. Why this is the first thing? Because the wire is small, so if you lift the tank too much then this might accidentally break. So you just simply have to pull this. I'm doing it with one hand. It is very easy to do. See this? Now we disconnect this water drain hose.
and now we remove this fuel gauge coupler. It is very easy to remove this fuel gauge coupler also. You just have to press this and pull it out. You have to press this and pull this out. So the final thing that we would be removing is this fuel pump, this fuel supply pipe. By pressing this quick release button, there are quick release button on both sides. Tighten the tank a little bit more using this wooden lock, which wooden lock, and put it in place. You just have to press these two buttons, one on the front, one on the back. But it is easier to do. Just press these two buttons in the front on the back, and just pull it up. It will come off. The fuel would come out, and it is okay.
So now we have taken everything, every coupler off, all five connections off from under the tank. The water drain hose, the fuel pump coupler, the main fuel supply line, the evap hose, and the fuel gauge coupler. After that, I would remove this lock and just hold the tank from back like this and from front like this, and just simply just lock it carefully. Just pull it out. Just hold the tank like this here. Just pull it out.
So this is the underside of the tank, guys. See, let me just show you what is there. This thing you see, this is your fuel pump, this white plastic part. Then this black one is your inline fuel filter, and this one is your fuel gauge. This one is your fuel gauge, and these two sockets on either side of the tank, underside of the tank. These rest here on the frame. These rubber bush you see on both sides of your frame. See, on this side also, and under the tank. Under the tank we have got this brake hoses and these electrical lines, and this is our ABS modulator, and this is our fuel rail, which is connected to our throttle body, and this is our evap pipe which is going to the evaporation unit. It is located somewhere above the main stand. This is our drain hose. This hangs below openly so that the water can get out. And again, there is a electrical socket. This is a socket which provides supply to your fuel pump.
So guys, now is the time to put the tank back. दोस्तों, अब हम टैंक को वापस लगा देंगे. You just have to carefully hold the tank like this and just place those two bracket that we have under the tank over the rubber bushes that we have on the both side of our frame. Just press it in. Just match these holes. First thing we connect is our fuel line. It's very easy. Just push it down into the fuel rail and it is self-connecting. Then we'll just connect this water drain hose from this side. From the right side, we'll just connect the fuel gauge coupler easily. It will just slot in easily. Just press it and it will slot in easily. Then just lower the tank a little bit. Fix the rest of the things. Just put the drain pipe back. Then just simply put the log under here, and just then finally just put this fuel pump coupler back in.
See, this fuel pump coupler is in back in its place. You just have to slot it in. We have already fixed the the drain pipe back, the fuel line back, the fuel gauge, the fuel pump coupler back, and the fuel gauge coupler from that side back. All we have to do, so all we have to do now is just to put this evap hose back in its place. Just push it like this in its place and it will hold it in its place.
So now the final step, guys, just put these bolts back. So now for the final step, just put these bolts back in its place. Just tighten these up. Just put your seat back. Just put your seat back and we are done. Just put the key in and start the motorcycle just to check that there is no fuel leakage, means the fuel line is connected properly. Thanks guys, and thanks for watching. Hope this would help you in removing your fuel tank and putting it back on your motorcycle whenever you need it. Whatever you intend to do after removing your fuel tank, either you want to clean the underside of the tank or you have to work on your throttle body or some of your cables. Thank you, dosto. Thanks for watching.